My name is Janine Werner, and I grew up in Maryland. I was born in New York, and for my medical training, I decided I wanted to experience New York again, and so I went there and spent a decade in New York City in the 1990s, and it was awesome. So I've lived in the Annapolis community for now over 20 years, and I really feel part of the community, and I really feel that by taking care of patients in this community that I serve an important purpose. So usually people come to us with a known diagnosis. Usually they've had a mammogram, they've had a biopsy, sometimes they've already had their surgery and they get sent to us. Other times patients will come with some abnormal lab work or some weight loss and we'll do an investigation to try to figure out what's going on. And in those cases, we're the ones who make the diagnosis of the cancer. Patients come in wanting a plan and they want to understand what's going on. And so by giving them information, I can then explain to them why the plan is going in the direction that it's going and why we would focus on certain elements of their cancer. Every patient is different, and so every person deserves a personalized approach that has to do with their specific circumstances, whether it has to do with their particular tumor or their particular other health status or their family needs or their personal beliefs. We opened the Annapolis Division of MOH to be able to provide patients with care that was convenient and accessible and evidence-based. And so parking is easy and our lab is on site and our infusion nurses are on site. So patients can come and see their doctor and get their infusion in the same place. I know I've done a good job in a new patient visit when they come in with a huge list of questions and I go through all of the information that I want to impart to them. And at the end of the visit, we then review the questions. And my favorite thing is when I've managed to answer all the questions on their list without them even having had to ask them. It's really important for the patient to be heard because the patient's needs are really what has to be paramount in the care of their cancer.